Hello, everyone. This is Vortex 259, back after an extended vacation. I've been doing lots of stuff during my time off. As a matter of fact, I just got back from my annual fishing trip in Colorado. I'd like to thank you for tuning in to a brand new episode of Let's Play Final Fantasy IV Advance. The last time we met, we guided Cecil, Palom, Porom, and Tella to the top of Mount Ordeals. Now, Porom blamed her mischievous brother Palom for the strange noises that could be heard on the summit, but it turned out to be the Fiend of Earth, Scarmiglione, and his pet Skullmance. They were easily defeated, though, so now we can continue to the west to see what's on the other side of this bridge. So let's continue onward here. Oh no, what now? It's that voice again!
Fools! My true strength lies in death. Join me in hell.
Oh no, it's Scarmiglione again, and he gets a back attack on the party, and he's much stronger.
This is my true form. Die.
Well, he gets a back attack on the party, but he's such a slowpoke. Cecil gets to go first, and I'm going to have him use the row command to take Cecil to the front row and put those weak mages in the back row. That slowpoke, he had the chance to strike first and he missed it. Well, the true form of Scarmiglione is going to be a little bit stronger than the previous one, naturally. He has 3,523 HP this time. Now, he has very low defense, so weapons will work well against him. He is a zombie now, so he's going to be weak against fire and holy. Throw weapons also work well against him, so if you have some arrows in your inventory, you might lob those at him for some decent damage. Now, he does absorb ice, so don't try using the blizzard spell against him. As far as his special attacks go, his physical attacks are strong, especially if you keep your weak mages in front, so definitely put them in the back row for this battle. His physical attacks can poison you as well. Now, he can also use a Song of Curse on all of your party members. If you become cursed, your attack and defense will be reduced by half. Alright, well, it is Porom's turn here. What I'm going to have her do is cast the Protect spell on all four party members. And I'm going to have Cecil attack with his sword. Now, as far as Tella goes, I'm going to have him stay on standby for curing. And Asuna, if necessary. We'll use Asuna if somebody becomes cursed. However, I think I do have a staff still in the inventory, so if somebody becomes poisoned, I'll just have him equip that and have him use that on the person that is poisoned. But for this turn, I'm going to have Tella use the Blink spell on Porom, kind of make a double image of her, make her harder to hit. Now, the most powerful person in this battle is going to be Palom, and he knows it. He's going to use his Fura spell for the most damage against Scarmiglione here. Let's see how much damage that does. Oh yeah, 938. And when you use magic against him, he will use the Song of Curse. And fortunately, nobody became cursed this time. So let's see what we can do. I tell you what we'll do, since he's weak against Holy, let's have Porom use a Cura spell on him. And let's go ahead and have Tella blink up Palom in the back row there. Make him harder to hit. Oh, this is such a cinchy battle so far. How in the world did you get to become a fiend, being such a weak villain? I'll tell you what, that was one of the glitches going on there, so I'm just going to have Cecil defend this battle to make it a little more even, but still, this is a pretty easy battle. Alright, let's have Porom, I guess, just cast Cura for some more damage. And, okay, here's a good chance to use that staff. Let's just replace Tella's Ice Rod with the staff. Scroll back up to the top here and have him use the staff against himself, or on himself, I should say, to remove that poison. There we go. Now, you can use a bluff command to have both twins pray, and it will take a while, and they'll use a flare attack or like a comet-type attack for some decent damage against Armiglion, but it's much quicker just to have Palom use his Fury spell. And you can see how easy this battle was in the GBA version. Now, if you're playing the DS version, this battle is extremely tough. So, don't expect it to be that easy if you're playing the DS version of this game. But here in the GBA version, they just made it a little bit too easy. It's a bit disappointing, but we win this battle, defeat our first fiend. We get 2,500 gil and 900 experience points. How could I possibly lose? Yeah, drop down there with the rest of the trash, Scarmiglion. So, we have defeated Scarmiglion, and we can now check some new entries in the bestiary. 18% completed now. Let's scroll down here to number 42 to find the entry for the Skullnance that we finished off earlier. 200 HP on those. Now, let's scroll way down here to find the next two entries. Number 213 is Skarmiglion's first form. You can see he had 3,500 HP. And lots of resistance. No weakness in his first form, but in the second form, he is an undead this time. And he has 3,523 HP. No treasure drops, but he did have those weaknesses available that we exploited to defeat him. So there you go. There's all those new entries in the bestiary. Now let's see what's over here to the west, finally. Hopefully we won't be disrupted anymore. Well, actually I was disrupted. That was a back attack by two souls and two ghouls, and they did more damage to my party than Skarmiglion did. That's sad. But Palom and Porom did level up after that battle. They're now level 16. Let's investigate this strange marker here.
My son, I...
Cecil says, son? Just who are you? What's going on here? It looks like a strange force is drawing Cecil, Teleporum, and Palom into this small room.
Through much sorrow have I longed for your coming. I shall now entrust you with my power. By doing so, my pain will only grow, but there is no other way.
And a sword of light makes its way into Cecil's hand. And light is surrounding him, and he is transformed.
Break from your past and overcome your darkness. Only then will you receive the holy power. You must fight against the Dark Knight you wish to rid yourself of.
Uh-oh. What's going on? There are two of them. Oh no, it's a Dark Knight coming out of the mirror to confront Cecil. Hey, look out! Cecil says, stay back. This is my battle to atone for my wrongs. So Cecil's going to have to face off against the Dark Knight all by himself. And in order to win this battle, you want to have Cecil just keep defending against the Dark Knight's Dark Wave attacks. If you attack the Dark Knight, you will not win, so keep defending, and eventually Cecil will prevail. Now, it may look like Cecil's going to be defeated here soon. Actually, what we can do is actually use Cure on Cecil. Cecil now has the ability to cure himself as a paladin. Just do not attack the Dark Knight, and everything will eventually be okay.
Some fight for law, some fight for justice. What will you fight for? One day you will see.
And Cecil prevails against the Dark Knight.
You have done well. Now receive my spirit as light, my soul, my light. With this you must stop Golbez. Farewell, my son.
Cecil says, please, wait. And the Dark Knight disappears. And Cecil has become a paladin. He has successfully completed the quest to become one on Mount Ordeals. And apparently, he's the first person to do so.